When we are doing univariate analysis, we're basically coming up with a number that tells us something about the variable that we're interested in studying. There's another way of doing that, and that's the use of tables and charts. We're doing the same thing with that, but instead of having one number, we're actually coming up with a visual representation of the data. So there's lots of ways of doing that. The most common way you'll see this in research studies, for example, is the creation of a frequency table. And Mitch is going to walk you through the steps of doing that, but basically what we're doing is counting all the attributes of a variable and putting them in a form that allows us to understand very quickly what the data look like. Another way that you'll see data represented is in charts and graphs. Some of the ones you're probably familiar with are pie charts and bar charts, for example. A pie chart is basically just a circle where certain parts of that pie represent percentages of the variable you're interested in talking about. As you know, we measure variables in three different levels: nominal, ordinal, or ratio. Once we know what level of measurement we have, that will determine the kind of chart that we draw. Now, for nominal and ordinal variables, we typically draw bar charts. And a bar chart looks like something you're probably very familiar with. Let's say gender, for example, is measured at the nominal level. So you have two categories, male and female, and we put those on the bottom axis, and on the side you would have frequencies and percentages. And then you would just have a bar that represents how high or how many people are inside each of those categories. It's a great way of looking at some data and understand what the categories look like in comparison to each other. Now, for ratio variables, we recognize that the categories are actually touching each other. So the bar chart looks a little different. In fact, it's called something different. It's called a histogram, and the bars are actually touching each other. So age is a great example here, where you have people who are 1 year old, people who are 100 years old, people who are 50 years old in the middle. So we have a sample of people that have this wide range of age. We line them all up in this chart and we put all those bars together. And then we could draw a line over those to show the distribution of that variable. So pie charts, bar charts, and histograms are great ways of showing visually what variables look like. And you've probably seen a lot of these. If you read the newspaper, especially like a newspaper like USA Today, they use those kinds of charts all the time. All right, there's one last chart we need to talk about, and it's called the line chart. Line charts are great when we're looking at, for example, time series data, data that are collected over long periods of time. So, for example, we might be interested in the number of homicides that take place in the city from 1980 to 2000. And so we can count the number of homicides that took place in 1980 and just put a dot on the chart. 1980, dot. 1981, another dot. 1982, another dot. And then we put a line that connects all those dots. The nice thing about this chart is it allows us to look at trajectory over time to see changes. What if we put a policy in place, for example, where the police did something different, a new strategy on fighting crime? We would want to look at the number of homicides taking place and then see if there's a decrease over time. That's the beautiful thing about line charts. It allows us to look at change over time. So as I said, there's lots of ways of visually representing your variables. Tables and charts both give us one glimpse at the variable, and just looking at it very quickly, we know what the variable looks like.